expect to be under a little bit of pressure, yeah. Expect the goalkeeper to make some good saves, which he did, which is great for Wes, because he's been a good pro. And you know, when the opportunity came for him to go back into the team, he took it, and he was outstanding. Scored two away from home to take the game deep, 80 minutes. They're positives. Negatives yet again is that, you know, if we do things a little bit different, if we make better decisions from a defensive point of view, if we defend properly individually and as a team, then we come away like we should have done in, and I'm only talking about the games I've been here, with so many more points than what we've got. We wouldn't be in this position, but we are, so that is a disappointing thing. You know, the ball goes in the back of our net far too easy. You know, they work hard. Yeah, not out of anything apart from being our best player. Can he handle the situation? Yes. Will he inspire and lead us? He did. Was he the best? I thought he was the best midfield player on the pitch for his age as a 20-year-old. Did he keep going into the game? Yeah, he made tackles, he was running around towards the end, he ran past a couple of our midfield players at times in the 90th minute, and he's a type of player that this football club has produced in the past, will continue to produce, and one that we're delighted to have him. And like I said, there was nothing in it apart from that was the right, correct decision. You know, I didn't need to explain it before, because I knew what the outcome would be, and you guys will obviously, you know, talk about that. A 20-year-old boy in the position that we're in and putting in them that type of performance.
Let's check on Oliver Burnie. There's reports that he's out for months now.
Well, he's going for a scan this week, so we'll get the results of that and obviously tell you off the back of that.
So how was James McAtee
like? Yeah, and Bogle came off injured as well. So, Bogle more precautionary, but McAtee came off injured. Yeah, he's suffered a groin injury. Yeah, I know obviously we'll talk about Sheffield United, but it does make me chuckle when people say they've got injury problems. When you look at our group and what we can put out and is available to us. So.
Obviously, a lot of the injuries have come to your leaders as well, which is why you're relying on the 20-year-old kid as captain. Do you need more of those sort of characters in the fullbacks?
100%, absolutely spot on. 100%. But listen, I still think that he might be captain, and we build around him. And he's humble enough, he won't get carried away. His performances have been incredibly consistent at the highest level, against Liverpool, against three of their midfield players, the way they press. He was best midfield player on the park against £200 million worth of talent against Chelsea. He was good at Brentford, and that was a different challenge. He was good on Saturday against Burnley, and tonight, you know, pound for pound for the kid. You know, in there, you know, against Ericsson and obviously Man United have got a special kid in there as well, and you know, he's going to the end, he's making really good decisions with the ball and without the ball. So, but going back to that, yeah, you know, there's so many things, Stu, that, you know, this is not the right time really to talk about it, but there's so many things that we have to get right, you know, on the training ground, on the pitch, off the park, in the changing room, in terms of everything that goes, that, like I've always said, getting that right, getting those players in, and working with them. And as I said, I don't think it's the right time really to talk about that at the moment. I think just talk about, say, maybe tonight's performance.
Was there ever even a shadow of doubt that it would be too much for him at his age?
No, because we've watched him, we've seen him in training, the way he acts, the way he goes about his business, and the way he's played previously. So, you know, and it should be, like I said, you know, I said it after Brentford, we've got to catch him up. and we did at times tonight. But like I said, it's another game, another yo-yo sort of situation from our point of view. Yeah, you know, I've got to understand the challenge as well. Like, we're coming to Old Trafford in the situation that we're in, and you know, we've just been beaten 4-1 at home by Burnley. So, you know, it is yet again another mixed bag in terms of my words to the players and to you about regarding our performance.
Just a bit more on the goalkeeper. I mean, it says a lot for his character.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Yeah. Listen, I made a decision when we bought Ivo in, and it hasn't gone as well as we want it to have gone. That's as simple as that, you know. So, we have to recognise that, you know, regardless who signs who, there are players, and we have to make big decisions. So that was a decision that we made, you know, this. He's a team player, Wes. You know, he's gone about his work very diligently and been a top professional, and he's doing what goalkeepers in this division, especially in our position, need to do. He's make some saves and make some big saves, and he's done that tonight.
And Brereton Diaz continues to do everything on
the
front. I mean, is there any prospect of
keeping? Well, we've, you know, of course, is, you know, there's work, you know, in terms of leading up to the next game, and there's work on a medium to a longer term basis in terms of, you know, potential, what we need to do, you know, on many fronts that we talked about. You know, you're talking about leaders and what we need to do on off the back of that as well. So, you know, he's done himself no harm at all. It's been a really good loan for him so far. Assists, and goals, and for me, an absolute dream to work with. Great in the change room. You know, fitted in fabulously. Didn't expect anything different, and delighted that we've had him. So we'll wait and see, and go with sort of that.
Bit before, you said you didn't want to talk about like what comes next, but you reeled off a lot of things that made it sound as though there was a lot of work in front of you from now until the start of next season or when the transfer window closes. Is it going to be hard? How difficult is this period going to be?
Listen, it's going to be hard. It's going to be intense. We have to get it right. So, yeah, listen, this is a lot of players out of contract. There's a lot of players returning to the parent football clubs. There's a lot of situations in terms of, you know, of availability on players this season that we have to make big decisions. There's options in there. It's, you know, I think it's always been looked at from quite a long time as this might be an opportunity to sort of rebuild, and especially in the position that we're in. You know, and the points total that we've got to go and rebuild the side again to be successful and to play how we wanted to play.